Ever wonder if the Starlink satellite dish will work inside? Well, we're about to find out. You go ahead and plug it in here. Now, I took it down because there was a storm outside and I did not have it mounted to the house yet because I'm not sure if I'm going to end up keeping this or not. We'll give it a few moments to go ahead and boot up. Now, I just noticed a high-pitched whine. I'm not sure if this microphone will pick it up. We got the little activity light here on the bottom, so it shows that it is at least powered on. So now I'm connected to the Starlink Wi-Fi, and it shows that it is offline and trying to determine the location. So I'll give this a good 10-15 minutes and see what happens. So it has been well over an hour, and it is still offline. So now I'm wondering if I can stick this in the trunk of my car and what kind of signal I get, if any. Let's go. So I've got the Starlink dish here. Put this in the back of the trunk. These cables and stuff up here and the router. And then I'm gonna take a extension cable here, feed this through the back window. And then plug it right in. Shows it is offline and it is about 11:57 right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and work on cleaning up my garage for a little while and come on back and see if it goes ahead and links up. So it has been well over 15 minutes. It is 12:24 p.m. and it still shows that it is offline, unfortunately. So I guess that means that I can't run it inside of the car. And there's already other videos on YouTube of people actually disassembling the dish and putting it up on the roof where they are able to get it to work. But I'm not willing to take it apart just because of the risk involved and how expensive it is. And apparently with this new dish, the new design, it's much more difficult to take it apart, and several other people have already damaged theirs trying to do so. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.